3, 2, 1.
Welcome to Antimatters.
Hello, everyone. Up today, we've got Ramirez, the Manica Rubida Queen, and her family, and we've also got an order from Antics. First up, Ramirez. As you can see, I recently gave the colony a meal of scrambled egg. I think they're definitely a fan of the scrambled egg. However, they have made a massive mess. For some reason, they decided to smush some of it between the top of the nest and the acrylic on top. Now it looks absolutely appalling. It doesn't help that I also overwatered them around the same time they had the egg, so it's kind of compounded the issue. I probably could get away with just leaving it until the nest dries out, and there is a chance that the girls would clean it up all nice. However, well, I'm not gonna wait. And I thought, well, I could take the lid off and clean it and put it back on. The only issue with that idea is these girls are very violent and very stingy. I pulled out the super pooter and one of my old hoovers and made sure that I was ready if any of the ants got out. I really don't want to get stung. The plan was to remove all the screws, and when the acrylic was loose, I could slide it sideways while replacing it with a different piece of acrylic to hold them in for a minute while I clean the original piece. I got straight to work undoing all the screws, and it was an absolute pleasure. I am a massive fan of Antics' little inserts for the screws, and it makes everything so much easier. The screws come out like pew, pew. Just to be on the safe side, I added a little bit of tape to the acrylic as well. Finally, it came to the last screw. I was absolutely terrified undoing this one, and I just kept a good firm grip on top of the lid so that none of them could escape no matter what happened. I then got to slide in the piece of acrylic over. This was so scary, and the ants inside were so pissed off. I managed to slide the lid off, however the new piece of acrylic at one point got a little bit stuck. Some of the sand that the Manica had put up on the ceiling had got a little bit trapped in the whole system. I quickly gave the lid a wipe on my leg and smushed all of the junk off before getting ready to put it back on. I was just as scared putting it back on as I was taking it off, and my hands were definitely shaking. Reattaching it went absolutely perfectly, better than I ever could have imagined, to be honest. And I was really happy to have the piece of acrylic back on and started putting the screws back in. I was extremely happy in the end that none had escaped, I hadn't got stung, and everything looked fantastic again. I'm a huge fan of these little nests from Antics. They've definitely served these girls really well. Now that the acrylic is clear again as well, you can see exactly what I mean. Like, there's so much brood now. The queen looks absolutely beautiful as well. Something I do like at the minute is the dynamics of who's in charge of the nest. When the colony was a little bit smaller, it did seem that the queen was kind of the dominant decision maker. However, that's starting to change, and her free will is being taken away by the workers who have decided, no, you're not leaving the nest and things like that. They'll physically kind of barricade her in and cover her completely now. I know they're only trying to protect her, but I do think Ramirez does get a little bit wound up by having these little workers kind of crawling all over her sometimes. And she does, every so often, just leg it. While filming, I also spotted this beautiful golden girl, and I think she's absolutely gorgeous. Safe to say, we're gonna have plenty more of these golden girls soon, because there's plenty of larvae. After watching these girls for a little bit, it kind of dawned on me that they might have actually outgrown this nest now, and it is slightly restricting their growth. So what I decided to do was, well, I jumped straight on the old internet, went over to Antics, and after the success of this nest, I bought the upgrade, which is, well, it's about double the size. I chose to get the free port one, so hopefully I can expand it further in future as well. But I think this will do them absolutely great. The design is really similar to the one they've got, which means there shouldn't really be any issues. I chose to go with the matching bamboo colour as well. I'm a big fan of the bamboo. Here's a little example as well of when the queen gets fed up with being kind of controlled by the work. With my order in though, all I had to do now was wait a couple days. And yeah, the package came super fast. Let's crack it open there. As you can see, it's got the standard Antics like packaging. I really do love their sellotape, it's quite cool. First thing, we got a little bit of, we got the packing slips and a little bit of corrugated cardboard stuff. I like this, nice and recyclable. Underneath, we have the stuff. Top right, we have the little nest for Ramirez and their family. I can't wait to plug in their upgrade. So what I did was quickly started getting it hydrated. So when I wanted to use it, it'd be all ready to go. As you can see here, I also bought the 13mm tube adapter. Also in this box, we have the Y Popeth. I've probably said that wrong, but Rich over at Antics reached out and asked, do you want a free Y Popeth? And I said, absolutely yes. I chose to go with a fern colour this time. It's so new as well, this fern colour, that it's not even on the little stickers yet. A few minutes after the box had come in the mail though, I was ready to start putting together the little Y Popeth, 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 Popeth. The first thing I did was take all the plastic off the acrylic. I haven't really got very good nails for this, so that was the right pain in the butt, but I did find that if I scuff up the corner with something else, I can pick it off. Took about 5 minutes though that. Once all the plastic was off, I got straight to trying to put it together. I didn't really have a clue what I was doing though, so I kind of thought, well, I'll put things where they would kind of fit in my head. Eventually, I half figured it out. This video should definitely not be a guide on how to make it though, because I do make a lot of mistakes, but you won't see it until the end because that's when it becomes a real pain in the butt. I definitely recommend checking out the build instructions for this though. It's not a hard build, but it does have some things that are a lot easier if you do them in the right order. When I went to do up the tube rack screw as well, I realised that it was a little bit too long. If nowhere else has this problem, then these two little screws that came with it must be for the tube rack. I wouldn't know till the end of it though. I quite enjoyed building it though. I'm a real big fan of the acrylic that Antics uses. It's nice and chunky. Eventually though, I thought I had it all together. But I was wrong. Nope, I had to take the lid back off because I'd forgotten two screws inside. These are the ones that I should have done at the beginning. And yeah, they were a little bit tricky. Eventually got them back on though. Got everything else back together and swapped out those screws for the tube rack. It was ready to go, I think. Oh, nope, found some more screws on the bottom that I hadn't put it in. And bam, I think that's it. The little Y Popeth was ready to go. I think it's absolutely beautiful. I'm super, super excited to move some ants in. You can see it's got a nice size to it as well. I'm happy that I can fit one of my bowls inside, just because I can keep the floor a little bit cleaner then. The only issue I did have is some of the corner joints. There's a little bit of a gap between the corner joint and the ceiling. And if you do up the screws too tight, which obviously I did, it does delaminate the layers a little bit. Luckily for me, the ants that I want to put inside of it aren't too small, so I don't really have to worry about anything escaping out of any cracks. Overall though, really good build. It took about 30 minutes in the end. All of the screws were absolutely lush to do up because of the inserts. I got straight to trying to move some ants in. First thing I had to do obviously was stick some tubes on one side. On the far side, I added another little tube holder as well. That's where I was going to put the tube of Formica rufa. I chose to put this species in just because, well, they're doing all right in their test tube, but it's starting to get a little bit manky and pea coloured kind of thing. They've got, it looks like someone's weed in the test tube. Hopefully though, they'll enjoy this new little white Popeth, and it'll give me a little bit more access to get in there and clean them quite easily. The issue with Formica, as you may be aware, is if you disturb them, they run around like crazy little girls, and when you've kind of got a test tube, and if you disturb them and the test tube is open, you've got to quickly cap that thing or they're going to be everywhere. and it gets a little bit hard sometimes to feed them in it. In this setup though, I can add a barrier. For all the heat cable people out there as well, it has all the little notches to put your heat cable through. It is now just a waiting game. I hoped that the Formica roofer would move in quickly. I wasn't expecting much though. Let's get back over to Ramirez though. With her upgrade in hand, it was time to sort them out. As I said earlier, I got the little 13mm tube adapter for this one. That's because the current one they're living in also has the 13mm tube attachment on it. I've got the new nest all ready with the tubes, and I've used a couple of my tube joints to join them all together. I'm hoping it'll be as simple as quickly unplugging the old nest, plugging it into one of the tube joints and plugging the whole thing back into the nest. But you never know with ants. I did distract them with a little bit of sugar water in hopes that it might keep them a little bit calmer. It didn't though, and all it did was encourage the queen, as you can see here, to come out and have a snack. With the queen outside though, it's kind of a bit risky to do anything. I had to wait a while. Eventually she was back in though, and I quickly, with my little pair of bent nose tweezers, prodded in some cotton wool to the tube. The plan? Unplug it, and then the ants couldn't get out of the nest, and I wouldn't have to worry about that for a few seconds. I could quickly get the new pipe onto the outworld, and bam, it was straight in. Actually went quite smooth to be honest. Getting the cotton wool out of that bit of tube though wasn't as easy. One of the workers got out, you can see her on the lid. After I flicked her in though, they were ready to go. It did not take them long to start exploring. This is about 5 or 6 seconds after being plugged in, and bam, they're already running into it. I totally wasn't expecting them to do it this fast, and that's why the camera is a bit blurry there. They were straight in. They're so full of confidence, these girls. It's one of the things that makes them really good to watch, because if you put food in like this straight on it, it's like, what's this? I want to know. Can I eat it? Now that they've got more room to grow, it took me about 30 seconds as well to give them a real big meal. I can start kind of plumping them up a bit now. Long term, I am definitely hoping to get more of these little modules and make a nice big Antics modular setup. When I went back a couple days later to check on them, they'd all moved out too, so they obviously like this new nest. There's still some of them in the old setup, but it seems most have migrated to the bigger chambers. A big thank you to Antics as well for the Popeth. I definitely recommend all of their nests, to be honest. I've had some amazing results with the Biffin back though. That's what the Manica were originally in, and it's also what my Pogona Myrmex Barbatus are in. And if you haven't seen them in a video, they're doing absolutely brilliant in theirs. I think this is quite an accomplishment, because the Manica like it wet and the harvesters like it dry, and the nest seems to cater to both species really, really well. They're booming. Anyway, that's all for today. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Until next time, may your ants live long and prosper. Have a fabulous week. And bye!